यू गॉट मी, कट करो. Hi all, so I've got a very very interesting guest for you, and we are launching a series called Feeders. We'll be getting some female leaders who are doing wonderfully in their career. और उन्होंने ये कैसे किया, क्या कर रही है और उनसे हम क्या हेल्प ले सकते हैं, वी आर गोइंग टू नो. सो भूषिता, वेलकम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल.
थैंक यू सो मच.
एंड इट हैज बीन आई थिंक मोर देन 2 ईयर्स दैट वी हैव बीन ट्राइंग टू डू दिस, बट फाइनली आज हमें मौका मिला है. 12th ऑफ दिसंबर ऑन संडे दैट वी आर डूइंग दिस. सो भूषिता, लेट्स स्टार्ट राइट अवे. सो हाउ आर यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल?
आई एम डूइंग वेरी वेल, सो हैप्पी टू फाइनली मीट यू आफ्टर सो लॉन्ग.
Great, thank you. So, Bhushita, what have you been doing these years? I mean, let's say last couple of years, 2, 3, 5 years. Can you just give a glimpse?
So, I have been a chess player since I was 7 years old, and I have been extremely passionate about this game. My brother and I both have represented our country internationally, and we have spent our entire life playing chess. And 2020, when COVID happened, we realized that we wanted to take our passion for chess to the next level, and we wanted to teach underprivileged kids.
Oh, wow, that's amazing.
Thank you.
So I can also learn.
Yes, definitely, for sure. So that's the idea behind Samvedna Foundation, which we started in 2019.
Okay.
And in December. And through this foundation, we have been able to touch 7 states across the country and teach 400 plus underprivileged kids.
And was that offline tha or online tha?
Ye online tha, because COVID mein sare matlab slums mein jaakar sikhana was not possible. So we actually did start offline. We started in 2 slums of Delhi, but then COVID jaise hua, we shifted everything online.
Great, great. So let's talk about, and you have to hook up because we are going to give you very very good learning, what you can learn in real life from chess and how she can benefit you all. Okay, so let's talk something about chess. So when did you had your first interaction with chess? The very first time.
Okay, so this was when I was 7 years old, and my mother had read in a book, parenting book, that teaching your kids chess can really improve their memory and it can help inculcate patience inside them. So she thought it was a good idea for her to teach her kids how to play chess. And ऐसे ही हम लोग बैठे हुए थे उनके कमरे में, एंड लाइक दे टीच स्नेक्स एंड लैडर्स एंड कैरम बोर्ड, वैसे ही लाइक जस्ट लाइक एनी अदर बोर्ड गेम.
So, Bhushita, can you highlight कुछ ऐसी चीजें जो हम लोग अपनी लाइफ में सीख सकते हैं थ्रू चेस? Because I think it's a brainy game, right?
Definitely.
So, ऐसी कौन सी, let's say, top 3 things that they can learn from chess?
Sure. So, number one thing that I learned from chess is never to give up. There is a piece on the chessboard, the pawn, which only moves forward and it does not turn back. मतलब चेस में पॉन जो है वो आगे एक स्टेप बढ़ता है, वो पीछे नहीं बढ़ता. सो दैट हैज ऑलवेज टॉट मी दैट वी शुड ऑल्सो कीप मूविंग फॉरवर्ड इन लाइफ एंड वी शुड नॉट टर्न बैक. सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट वी ऑल स्टार्ट इन आवर लाइफ एज पॉन्स, बट द पॉन व्हेन इट रीचेज द 8th rank, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड क्वीनिंग ऑफ द पॉन, इट्स अ स्पेशल मूव इन चेस, 8th rank पे पहुँच कर जो पॉन है वो क्वीन बन जाता है. सो वी ऑल स्टार्ट लाइफ you know, as pawns, but if we stay consistent to our path, then we have the opportunity of becoming a queen, which is the most powerful piece.
So we can extract consistency as the keyword, right?
Definitely.
And by pawn, if I'm not wrong, that's sipahi.
Yes. Weakest piece on the board to the most powerful piece on the board. And the third thing that I learned from chess is that queen is the most powerful piece on the board, and that just tells us that, you know, women have all the strength in the world and they can do whatever they want.
Yes, women, for me also, my teachers, my parents, my mother, it's स्पेशली वो कहते हैं ना कि हर फीमेल होती है कामयाब इंसान के पीछे. सो आई हैव बीन वेरी लकी, आई हैव गॉट गुड फीमेल्स लाइक यू, लाइक माय मदर, लाइक माय टीचर्स हु हैव टॉट मी अ लॉट. सो समराइजिंग, लर्निंग फ्रॉम चेस, इट हैज टू बी नेवर गिव अप एटीट्यूड, एंड दैट इज कंसीव्ड बाय द मूवमेंट ऑफ पॉन्स. देन वी हैव कंसिस्टेंसी, एंड देन वी हैव क्वीन हैज द पावर, राइट? एवरीबॉडी कैन, एवरीबॉडी इज एक्चुअली अ क्वीन, दे जस्ट नीड टू मैनिफेस्ट देयर वर्क एंड ग्रो अप, राइट?
100%.
So let's move on. I'm sure ये जो भी आपने किया है या कर रहे हैं, you must have faced some challenges, right? Can you highlight some challenges and some learnings that we can also apply?
Sure. So I would like to talk about my experience when I was starting Samvedna. There was to raise funds for this social initiative. Okay. I had to organize a chess tournament. And I had to call a lot of players. And the first week of marketing, we were expecting to get a lot of registrations, but we ended up only getting like one or two registrations, and we were extremely disappointed because there were so many efforts that we were putting in for this event, and it was almost as if we were about to call off the whole event because of this, because of the less entries that we got. Because there was no point of investing so much money if no one was showing up. But we decided not to give up, and we began to change our strategies to be able to get our participants in. And humne logo ko personally call karne lag gaye. We used to call parents and tell them ki aap please apne bacche ko khilao is tournament mein. And then that personalization and that all that effort, hum school se ghar aate hue, we are calling, Havik's calling 10 parents, I'm calling 10 parents. So that really paid off, and total 250 players took part in this event.
And you mentioned about Havik is a brother, right?
Yes.
And he's also supposed to join in. So yes, two things that I can conclude from here is that you adapted to the situation.
Yes, definitely.
And second thing, you had some original plan, but you had some changes according to the situation, right?
Yes.
So as we mentioned about Bhavik, Shaitan ka naam liya, Shaitan hazir. So but Bhavik is not Shaitan, and Bhavik is very, very intelligent guy. I'll tell you something about Bhavik. So he has written a book, and he recently has participated in championship. I think Serbia, right?
Yeah.
So Bhavik, anything about that experience that we can learn from?
Yeah. So essentially, like in July, I was basically practicing chess on my own for a very long time, for around 1.5 years since Corona started. And especially after we started with Samvedna, that we were contributing towards the society. But I always wanted to take my game to the next level and actually pursue my passion for chess as well. And I was around the 1600 pity rating mark for a very long time, and I wanted to break the barrier and cross around 1800, 1900 by this year. So so back in 2020, I was just 13, and I had never imagined that it would be possible for me to go to Serbia and actually travel alone for over 20 days and participate in 3 tournaments.
You must have enjoyed.
Indeed, definitely.
What's your age currently?
Right now I'm 14 years old.
Wow, so I could have never imagined doing something like that in when I was 14.
So it was like a massive experience.
So what's your rating right now?
Right now it's 1879 per day, and online I've crossed around 2500, so online is a lot more,
Great, and where do you aim for the ratings?
My aim is to get to a title next year, so that's one aim which I'll definitely try to pursue, and other than that.
Great, I'll take tips from you for my things. Okay, so how do you manage, Bhavik? You're studying, right?
Yeah.
You're studying in 10, you have boards, you have everything, you have friends, social media. How do you manage focusing on such a great thing?
Yeah, so essentially before the exams, I don't exactly play chess too much and try to disconnect myself from social media and other things which can basically waste a lot of time, and try to give my 100% focus in studies. But before that, I try to manage my time and always have a schedule ready so that I can like devote my time half towards academics and half towards chess or any other social initiatives, so that I can just manage my time efficiently and try to utilize it to the maximum.
So I'll hit on that point. So connecting social media.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of noise that I've called somewhere, I've written somewhere. So it's called digital dementia, wherein we are into social media and we are not accountable. So if we become accountable, we see 4, 5, 7, 8 hours going down social media. So what advice would you give to us as a viewer and to them who are watching us? Disconnect kaise hona hai, and is there any loss by disconnecting? That's what I want to know.
Yeah. So essentially, you should disconnect from social media in a way that you basically make a cap amount of time that you spend over there. And after that, you just don't look at your phone. And the thing is, there's a sort of addiction with social media. So once you just click on one reel, you'll end up watching 10, 15 reels because you're just addicted to it and want to see a bit more.
And then hours going in.
And just that, just like that, you drain like 2-3 hours just watching reels or just something which is like just not useful at all.
Right.
So instead of doing that, you devote like, okay, 30 minutes, that's all I will spend on Instagram or something. And then you just like, you know, keep a timer alongside. So there's like all these websites are very like professional and they're very advanced. So you can keep timers that after 30 minutes, they'll give you a ping that, okay, you've crossed 30 minutes now.
Okay, and then you can
yeah,
stop.
And so after that, you should just have to be strict with yourself and just not.
Okay. And then, Ushita, do you also do something like that?
So I believe ki too much of anything is bad. And social media can be a wonderful tool if you want to really expand your social initiative or you want to network with people from all over the world. Because a lot of our success with Samvedna and our other initiatives is because of social media as well. So it's not like you should not be on social media, but you should just use it in an effective manner. And like Bhavik said, you know, try not to get addicted to it, try not to waste time on it, but use it for your own benefit.
Right.
And especially on social media, we as teenagers, we intend to compare ourselves with the lives of others and we try to just, you know, try to see what's going on in everyone else's life. But that is not important. We should be concerned about ourselves, not about what is going
right,
on.
Right, so if I have to summarize that in a keyword, so you talk about balance,
yes,
balancing
definitely
how much time you spend.
Definitely.
And second, we must remember our objective, why we are on social
exactly,
media.
Yeah,
because
exactly,
there was a time when there was no social media and still we were doing fabulous, right?
Yeah.
But now it has to be an added advantage. It should complement,
definitely,
right?
Yeah,
it should
definitely
not be a supplement to
yeah,
something
exactly
else,
yeah,
right? You are studying, you are in 12th class, right?
Yes,
if I'm
yes
not wrong, and you're 10th, right? You'll be appearing for your board exams this year?
Yeah.
Online, offline?
Offline.
Great. So let's talk something about education system because I have deep roots in that. I have some beliefs. Let me see if I'm wrong or right. So do you see some flaws in education system? I won't say flaws, but it was designed much before our time, new age generation. So do you think there is any flaw?
Definitely.
And if you think
yeah
any flaw, what are the probable solutions?
Okay, so I think I'd like to take different boards as an example for this. So as you can see, CBSE and ICSE are the main boards in India because they're Indian boards. And however, there are a few other boards which also exist. So both of us are a part of IGCSE and IB, which are essentially international boards. And I'd just like to say that they differ a lot from like what the Indian boards are. And the thing with Indian boards is that while the knowledge is extremely deep and you can actually learn a lot from it, the thing is you just have to rote learn it. And once you're given the exam, you end up forgetting all the knowledge you've like gained from a very long time. And it just all goes down the drain. So instead of doing that, what the foreign boards essentially do is that you do get the knowledge, but in the exams, you don't just have to rote learn it and give it all. You have to apply your knowledge and write essays about them. And when you do that, you just have to remember and store it in your long-term memory. And from that, you can actually write essays and apply it for even general things.
Okay, so that
yeah
talks about articulation. What do you
exactly
feel, what is in your mind,
exactly,
you need to articulate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not about reproducing something that
yeah
you learned at a particular time.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right.
So like a solution for Indian boards could be that they could possibly just like, instead of, you know, just rote learning and writing 2-3 mark answers, which will just fetch you marks and not knowledge. The thing which they should do is that, like the foreign boards, they should promote more articulation, as you just said, and you should try to write more essays and apply the knowledge which you have learned, because that's the only way through which you can learn this and store this in your memory for a long time and actually use this in your daily lives to grow as a person. So
great,
that's important.
So navigating to two more points about education system, Bhushita something has to say. So Bhushita, let's talk about life skills. So, do you think the Indian education system goes into giving life skills or something on those lines? What do you feel?
I believe we lack a lot of learning for trying to learn life skills in our system of education, because I personally feel like I'm very dependent, and this is one flaw I have with my own self that I really want to overcome. And if our education system could teach us the basics, like, you know, say cooking or like cleaning our own rooms, which are essential for survival, then we would really be very better off to face the real world. And another flaw that I feel that our education system really has is that we are tested based on our ability to answer rather than our ability to question.
Wow.
Because we really need to, you know, to be able to actually learn, we need to learn to, you know, we need to have curiosity. That is the end all be all thing. And I would like to add that the Gurukul system, I think, is fabulous.
Yes,
and
exactly.
Maybe we should go back to our roots and probably try to inculcate some of the, you know,
methods and
yes,
the procedures.
Exactly, that were followed back there.
So yes, it's really important, the art of asking right questions
right
at the right time. People, आपने भी फील किया होगा, मेरे बहुत सारे दोस्त हैं, they were toppers and they are struggling with their life.
Exactly.
And somewhere mediocre and average, but they are doing extremely wonderful in their career.
Definitely.
Right? So yes, so take away from that education system is towards life skills and changing some procedures. A quick two or three tips, how should we go about it, or how the students who are watching should go about it. Quick three tips. Bhavik or Bhushan, anyone? About your Bhushyad, you have also
yes,
gifted me that book. What's that book all about?
Yes.
I know it, but I'd like to know from her. Yeah.
So my book is called Open Your Wardrobe for Answers, and it is based on clothing psychology. I was extremely fascinated to understand that, you know, there is a subject where your dressing style and your dressing sense can actually say a lot about your personality. So I wanted to explore that, and I have explored subjects like color psychology, why we dress to impress, how we can dress for success, and other
and
topics.
There are things like, I have also read that book, on which days, on what colors
yes,
to prepare.
Yes.
So that's amazing, pretty well. It taught me a few things that I did not know. Bhavik and Bhushita, quick two or three tips that you like to give to our students who are watching this in Hindi English both, so they can take immediate action right after this video.
Okay, so I think the number one tip I would say is that just stop thinking that knowledge is limited to your textbooks. Start exploring knowledge from everywhere. Try to be a good listener. Try to absorb and try to learn from everything around you.
And every people around you.
Definitely.
Like, जब भी क्या होता है, हम चाय पीने जाते हैं, पैटीज खाने जाते हैं, वी डोंट प्रेफर टॉकिंग टू दैट गाय, वी प्रेफर इन आवर फोन.
एग्जैक्टली.
बट अभी मैंने कुछ लोगों से सीखा है, सो व्हेनेवर आई गो टू परचेज समथिंग, आई टॉक टू दैट वेंडर.
एग्जैक्टली.
एंड ही हैज लॉट मेनी थिंग्स टू से.
Exactly.
He is full of experience.
Why? Sabke andar itna experience bhara hai. If we just try to observe and try to, you know, try to just keep our ears open, we will be able to grow every day.
Great. And Bhavik, one from you.
Yeah, so what I would say is that you should make studying and academics something which is fun for you, which you enjoy doing, and that way it will just be like, you won't imagine that how fast you'll go over all the syllabus, and it'll just stay in your memory, and you won't even think of it as a burden or something which you're just forced to do. So what I would say is that take this as an analogy. So when you're just going over YouTube watching random videos, it does not feel like a task. It feels like something which is very enjoyable and something which you're just having fun doing. Similarly, if you make study something which is fun to do, then it won't seem like a task, but it'll seem like something which you're in, like, you know, which you find very enjoyable, and like that's the best thing to do, because you have to make the dull studies and rote learning something which is extremely, like, you know, fun
bright
to do.
Fun,
and when you do that, you can just go over all the syllabus much faster.
Just like
so,
cooking
yeah,
Maggie and
just
eating Maggie.
Add a bit more colors to whatever studies you're doing.
Great, great. So that's very good. Good thing about education system. Let's move on. Okay, so now as I talked about in the beginning, that about feeders. So I am doing some series wherein feeders would mean female leaders, the acronym that I've made. So you being a female leader, young female leader, so Bhavik, we have to obey Bhushita now. So let's talk about challenges specifically related to females. You're a female, you must have faced challenges towards health, towards family. Maybe when you grow up, 30s, 25, so everybody has marriage pressure, social pressures. So would you like to talk about 3-5 challenges that a female specifically has to face that we don't have to face?
Yeah. Definitely. So I think the number one challenge that females face is gender discrimination. There is a lot of gender discrimination. There's a lot of gender stereotyping that is there in our society. If you look at chess as an example only, tournaments are completely male dominated. There are very few females.
Let's talk about percentage. Out of 100 people, how many are females and males?
I would say 10 are females out of 100.
So 90% and 10%.
Yeah.
Huge disparity.
Definitely.
I'd actually like to add to this point.
Yeah, please.
So the thing is that why female discrimination and gender discrimination is a thing which can go against females as well. I think you can use that as a strength to increase your power. Because at least if you take chess as an example, if you just compare females and males, then in the female sector, there are separate tournaments for them. And you can either play in the girls' category or the open section. So the boys' section is not exactly like limited to boys. Even girls can participate in the open section.
So we'll have a contrast.
So they basically have two choices.
Great,
they can either choose between the two.
So Bhavik would be for males and Mushila would be for females. Okay, so that is one challenge of discrimination. Okay, next one.
Then I feel that definitely getting finance, and like there are a lot of families that don't support. I am very blessed to be in a family that supports me a lot, but there are many families where, you know, they just try to get them to complete their education and then they implore them to marry and then just settle down. Live their life. But I feel like that should be completely their choice and the way they want to live, the way if they want to get into a relationship or not, that should be completely up to them.
That's the keyword I get here. The power of choice is not with them,
exactly.
Right? And for males, they have the power of choice.
Definitely.
Great. So the power of choice has to be any solution towards this, if you want to highlight. So if you have discrimination, if you have, if you don't have power of choice, what to do?
I think the number one is to build your confidence, because as a female, you have to face a lot of restrictions. You have to face a lot of judgments. Society has different views. You might have different views, but if you are able to take your stand, and that is only possible with confidence, then no one can shake you. Because there are so many female leaders that you can see in this world who have, who are like idols, who are icons, who we all, you know, aspire to be like. Rani Lakshmibai, for example. Any female leader who has been a great achiever, who has achieved a huge success and who is an inspiration for all others, is an inspiration because of her confidence and her conviction, because she does not move from her stand, does not get affected by what society says. Mark your
So two keywords here, the confidence and the conviction.
Definitely.
And we all agree, Bhavik, right? Even we also need to have a great confidence and a good conviction, but for females I think it's slightly better. Great, so confidence and conviction. So I also got to know Bhavik and Mushita, both of you are writers. You've already published some work and still aspiring more, right? So Bhavik, about your writing work.
Yeah, so essentially in January this year, I published my own book called The World of 64 Squares, which essentially has everything that you need to know about chess to at least get to a fair rating level. And the good thing about this is that I actually wrote this in wrote this over 1.5 years with all my notes about chess. But for the publishing part, I did that like absolutely myself in 3 days, so that I could publish this on my birthday. So my 14th birthday, I published the book. So that was something like
great. That has something in common with me and you, I'll tell you later on. So it taught me a lot, the few things about dressing that I did not know.
You asked us a lot of questions.
Yes, I am this topic.
Now it's our chance.
So I'm stuck.
To interview you. So we know that you've written a book recently.
Right.
And
how did you get to work? That's secret.
Our story is also in the book, and we are very, very blessed to be a part of it. But yes, we really want to know, what was your inspiration to write this book?
So I had my own struggles, everybody has. So पहले तो जितनी अंदर चीज़ें थी कहीं ना कहीं निकालनी थी. सो आई हैड रिटन इट लॉन्ग टाइम बैक व्हेन आई वाज इन कॉलेज, बट उतनी मेच्योरिटी नहीं थी, उतनी एक्सपीरियंस नहीं था. सो ऐसे चल रही थी लाइफ. देन आई स्टार्टेड ऑब्जर्विंग थिंग्स. समबडी टोल्ड मी कि ऑब्जर्व किया करो. सो आई स्टार्टेड ऑब्जर्विंग एंड वॉट एवर आई ऑब्जर्व इन द डेली रूटीन. सो आई हैड अ रूटीन ऑफ 4:30 इन द मॉर्निंग, समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो एक दो घंटे का जो टाइम होता था, अपार्ट फ्रॉम फोन आई डिडंट टुक माई फोन विथ मी. एंड मैं वॉक पे जाता, आई जस्ट ऑब्जर्व, चाय वाला हो, बच्चे हो, एंड जो भी मैं ऑब्जर्व करता था आई स्टार्टेड राइटिंग इट डाउन. सो ऐसा चलता रहा 3-4 महीने. देन आई रेड अगेन व्हाट आई हैड रिटन एंड आई फील वाओ, ये तो बहुत अच्छा लिखा है मैंने. सो आई थॉट व्हाई नॉट टू पुट इट इन टू बुक. सो देन आई हैव ऑल्सो हैबिट ऑफ रीडिंग बुक्स. सो बुक पढ़ता गया एंड सम हाउ आई फेल्ट यू नो कनेक्टिंग द डॉट्स. सो द डॉट्स वर कनेक्टेड एंड ओके नाउ लेट्स डू इट. सो आई स्टार्टेड राइटिंग. It took me, I think, 3 years. I did my own research about this patient, the question that I asked, the feeder series about the females. Everything suddenly connected and I felt like, okay, somebody is guiding me to write. So I wrote and then I went on a TEDx platform that I told you, Hansraj College. So I was gifted a book and in that book there was the name of the publisher. Luckily, it happened with me and I went to the publisher, took the consultancy, how things, and they guided me, okay, and then I was it. So now, yes, the date is 17th of December to be
amazing.
Launched. And you'll be getting an author's copy book. And yeah, you can learn a lot from that book. So it's not about me. I've written something that you can learn from experiential learning. Because har cheez hum khud experience karne ko jayenge, so life bahut short hai, right? So the best way to learn is the experiential learning that I prefer. And you can learn a lot from other experiences.
Yes.
So in a shorter span of time, you can accumulate so much knowledge. And itna kaafi nahi hai. So reading book doesn't help you. When you read book and you apply those things,
definitely.
Even one word or even one sentence, even one habit, that is going to change your life. So you must read it. I'll give it to you. And it has...
I'm really excited for it.
Has 9 chapters. It talks about the Paralympians, how they deal with their challenges, how they do the mental setup. And the confidence and the conviction that you talk about.
Amazing.
So these are something. And about the females also, yeah.
One more question about
please,
the book.
Please.
What is the one learning you feel that is the most important in the entire book?
In the entire book. So that's a very tough one to navigate, but I'll try. So one very important thing is that if you must have read somewhere, if you conceive something in your mind, you can do it. And nature conspires. Somehow I did not believe this system, but once I felt ek bar when I was in 7th class I was not studying well, then I decided okay I'll be the topper, and then I studied very hard for one year and then I became the topper. So that was a very easy thing for me after 1 year. So I conceived okay I can be this, I did that.
Yeah.
Then I decided to write a book, I conceived that, I did that.
Manifestation.
Yes. So this is really very important. So the point that you talked about, conviction and confidence. If you convict strongly that you can do this, of course you can do this. So it's all about you. So if you feel this, you can do it. If you don't feel, you cannot do it. And you have thousands of excuses to make. Ye nahi ho raha, wo nahi ho raha, financial support nahi hai, family support nahi hai. But when you want to do it, you can fight everything.
There's a way.
Yes. So yes. That is the one learning. And
amazing.
You have something more like jo cheez hame sikhai nahi jati. For example, communication skills. Actually, hame school mein sikhaya nahi gaya. It comes to communication. But shayad agar mujhe apne time pe sikhaya gaya hota, तो आज मैं और भी बेहतर होता. दो आई एम वेरी गुड बट और भी बेहतर होता लाइक यू. सो यस, देर आर सर्टन स्किल्स लाइक हाउ टू मैनेज सेल्फ. नो बडी टॉट अस हाउ टू मैनेज टाइम. यू लर्न योर सेल्फ, राइट? मे बी फॉर योर पेरेंट्स फ्रॉम बुक. सो आई लर्न माई सेल्फ. सो इफ समबडी टॉट यू और मी इन आवर गुड टाइम्स, आई थिंक दैट कैन हेल्प अस मैनेज बेटर. सो यू विल गेट लॉट ऑफ दीज स्किल्स वेर इन दोज आर नॉट टॉट, बट इट इज एक्चुअली दो स्किल्स दैट वी use, we utilize to work. Yeah, so those skills.
Amazing. So excited to read the book.
So it's coming in, and this video is a part of course that book that I told you.
Yes.
Okay, anything more you'd like to ask me? Then I have certain questions for you and then we'll wrap up quickly. Bhavik, you can ask me some questions.
Yeah, perhaps you could just explain a bit more that after college, you were actually like done with this book to a great extent, and then you talked about how like you like more maturity seeped into you, and then after a lot more years, you're actually now publishing it.
Yes.
So can you talk about the journey between after your college was over to now, and now that you're actually publishing?
Yes.
It?
Yeah. So Bhavik, you got my favorite word, journey. So the name of the book is actually The Journey to a New You. So I wrote that in college because I was struggling my own battles and fighting my own battles. Uske baad kya hua, so the focus of the book was about me, what I have done. But nobody has something to do with it. What I can learn from someone is my life, right? Similarly, what people can learn from that experience is what was missing. It was focused on me. So now I change the focus to you and the people who will be reading it. So that was one pragmatic decision that I took. And you must have heard ki kai baar ek step back lena padta hai. So I decided, okay, let's take a step back. And that was the time I started observing things.
Mm-hmm.
And see, I've learned one more thing. Everything happens at the right time.
True.
However hard you push, there is a time. Chai ko banne mein agar 3 minute lagte hai, to 3 minute lagenge. Aap kitne bhi flame tez kar do, it won't help, right?
Agree.
So you have to have that time sense. So slowly and gradually, I was getting time sense ki, okay, this is not the right time. There is something more that I have to do. And with those 4, 5, 6 years or maybe 10 years down the line, I met so many people who encouraged me, who enlightened me. I met so many institutions who told, for example, I recently went to Chennai and they told me about Sri Aurobindo Ashram, and their education system was really amazing that I wish to inculcate somewhere down the line. Then I met people like you who inspired me. So yes, the journey was really fruitful, and the decision, the pragmatic decision that I took to wait for the right time, and it was not stopping myself, it was exploring more.
Yeah,
but I didn't stop actually.
Agreed.
I took time to explore more, to experiment more, and then slowly and gradually I felt, okay, now the time is coming. So now if I see right away on this day, everything has fallen apart, luckily, and now the work is going on. So very, very good question, Bhavik.
Mm-hmm.
So thank you so much, Bhavik, for joining in. And Bhushita, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Let's wrap up this. And for you all, we all have one point to say. So one Bhavik would be there, one Bhushita would be there, and one point from me. So starting from female queen. So one point that you'd like to tell our audience.
I think we all should know opportunity costs in our life. क्योंकि बहुत ज़रूरी है कि हमें पता हो कि हमें किस चीज़ को प्रायोरिटाइज करना है बिकॉज लाइफ इज़ वेरी शॉर्ट एंड वी कैन नॉट पॉसिबली डू एवरी थिंग पॉसिबल सो वी नीड टू नो वॉट वी नीड टू पुट ऑल आर एनर्जीज इन एंड दैट इज़ वेरी वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर सक्सेस.
ग्रेट, सो दैट्स अबाउट प्रायोरिटाइजेशन. Great. And okay, one from you, Bhavik.
So I think even Rahul sir said this, that manifestations are very important, and then you have to give in your best 100% effort to actually achieve what you have planned and whatever your goals are. Thus, I would like to remind Swami Vivekananda's quote, "Utho, jago, aur lakshya ki prapti hone tak ruko." So the meaning is that once you set your lakshya or your goal, after that you just have to give it your 100% and then have the belief that you can reach whatever your manifestation is. And that, I think, is the most important step to success.
Great. And the point that I would like to highlight is the reciprocation of your point, actually, the fun thing that you talked about. So I would say whatever you are doing, you're playing, you're studying, you're shooting video, you're doing whatever, you should enjoy it. Unless and until you start enjoying it, you cannot succeed. So if you have to judge whether you are going in the right direction or not, you just ask yourself one question: are you able to enjoy it? And if you are able to enjoy, just forget everything and focus on that. That's it. So let's wrap up this video. Thank you so much for joining in.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bhavik. Thank you, Bhushita.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.